So we welcome in Christian Kirk to start us off here. Our kick and punt return specialist, our wide receiver, and our resident movie critic. And we will get to the Friday movie pre-Arkansas from up in Dallas a little later. We'll get his rating. But I think we have to start with the kickoff return against the Razorbacks. It was as electric as the one we've seen in a while. And for you, you know, I don't know. You've had five punt returns for mm-hmm. touchdowns in your career here. That was the first kickoff return. Are those maybe a little more electric than the punt return? Because it's always after another team just scored, mm-hmm. and it's the quickest answer that there possibly is.
Yeah, they can be. You know, I think a big part of it is, you know, the moment of the game and how big of a moment it is. You know, just which team ever has, you know, the momentum or whatnot, and just, you know, whenever a big play is needed. Obviously, kickoff returns are harder for sure, you know, just because just, you know, everybody has to have their block. If one guy misses their block, then, you know, the chances of you returning the kick isn't as high. And, you know, it's just kind of those, you know, that's why you don't see them as often. It's just because, you know, they're harder to execute and complete. So, that was awesome. You know, it's definitely up there and one of my favorites just because of the moment and the point in the game it was at. So it was fun.
You know, he provided some fascinating insight at the press conference earlier in the week when you talked about in-game adjustments. You know, we all know how great Coach Banks is as a special teams coach, where you said, and I'll let you tell a story, you said you saw something on one of the previous ones and the coach made an adjustment or two and said, hey, if everybody hits it, we're going to score.
Our game plan going into it, you know, we're supposed to hit them to the field all game, and they're crashing hard on the backside. I think it was the third quarter. You know, we changed the return to a boundary return. Me and Clyde actually ran into each other trying to catch the ball. Lack of communication between us two right there. And we were able to hit it up into the 25. But just with the hole that I saw inside, you know, I was able to come back to Coach Banks and said, hey, if we run that again and Clyde gets up inside there and, you know, we hit our block. So I was like, it's there. And so, you know, Coach drew it up on the sideline. And, you know, held up the card and, you know, everybody, you know, knew what they were supposed to do, knew their job. He said, if we hit this, you know, like you said, you know, we're going to score. And, you know, we went out there and executed.
And your group has a high level of confidence. We can see it when you guys take the field. But what does something like that do? An adjustment, you guys cash it in with a huge score. What does that do to boost that even more?
Yeah, it does a lot. And especially for the guys on the sideline, it boosts the morale for just the whole entire team. And I know the guys, you know, on the team that don't play special teams respect the guys that go out there and make special teams their pride and joy. I know it's one of my favorite things to do, you know, when I'm out there. And, you know, I take so much pride in it. You know, I know in high school it was just like, okay, yeah, I'm just a returner. I'm just back here, you know, just to, you know, try to make plays just because I'm good with the ball in my hands. And, you know, playing with other guys like, oh, man, I got to block or I got to do this. But to see guys actually want to go out there and do that and take pride in it, it's a fun group to be a part of. And the best thing is on Thursday we get ice cream sandwiches now for every return that we get. So Thursday walkthrough, we get some ice cream sandwiches for the return group.
That's good stuff.
No, Will, he in a pseudo roundabout way, he kind of called it this last week on segment three where he talked about how fast that track was and how much he enjoyed playing up there.
And then the two longest plays of your career right there in Dallas, the 81-yard reception and the 100-yard kickoff return.
Yes, sir.
And we had Shane Trapuca on Wednesday, and he came with Connor Lanphier. So Connor, appreciate him getting some special teams love out there.
Right.
But, you know, Shane mentioned he wouldn't punt to you. He thinks it's crazy that people do. But we also kind of went and talked about a later kickoff return. As exciting as yours was, if the 12th man, Cullen Gillespie, had broken one and scored a touchdown, he was saying AT&T Stadium may have come down and shaken at its foundation. I was thinking, Cullen, if he can get around this one guy, because he's coming toward our sideline, if he can get around this one guy, it's going to be a foot race with one other guy. I don't know if he'll win it, but he's got a shot. Now, that's all kind of happening in front of you, or I don't even know if you're in on the kickoff there because it was such a short one, but if you were, it's way out in front of you. Are you seeing it unfold and almost rooting for Cullen to make something happen?
Well, actually, we knew a short kick was coming.
Yeah.
We thought it was just going to squib it on the ground, and he kicked it up high. It was just a little pop kick. Whenever that happens, I got to run up there and make sure that we possess the ball. So I actually run all the way up to the front line, and Cullen's going to the right, and I'm kind of just watching him, and all of a sudden he gets hit, and he comes back around towards me. So now it's me and lefty Deshaun Capers going around the edge, leading him down the sideline. And I'm thinking the same thing. I'm like, oh, he might return this. So we're trying to seal the edge, and it was me and lefty trying to seal. And I thought lefty was going to take the guy that actually ended up pushing him out of bounds.
Okay.
And I was trying to seal for the guys in front. And, it was funny because Cullen's over there giving me a hard time. If you would have blocked him, I would have scored, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, hey, that's not me. You know, that's somebody else. But we were all joking. If he would have returned that, I'm not sure we could tell him anything else for the rest of the year. He'd probably just go off and do his own thing.
If he had returned that, though, what's the over-under on unsportsmanlike conduct penalties he would have gotten after scoring?
Oh, he's he at least would have gotten two.
But I'll tell you this. He did say, we asked him out the other day, he said he'd have gotten ejected.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, he would have.
Without a doubt.
He would have punted the ball into the end zone and then done a flip into those field-level suites.
That's what I'm saying. He probably would have gone into one of the suites and then
– poured beverages on himself.
whatever he had in mind.
Yeah. But you guys will look forward to South Carolina now, 1-0 in the SEC play. And that's basically all you're trying to do every week is be 1-0. That's kind of the mantra. But think about the South Carolina game in your first 2 years. Go back to the 15 game here at Kyle. Donovan Wilson has a pick six in it, and you guys won by a touchdown.
Yep.
Last year, they hit a big play right off the bat, first play from scrimmage, and it's kind of a dogfight to the end. You guys win a relatively close game. I mean, this team has played you guys tough, and I don't know if maybe it's the best South Carolina team that you'll face since you've been here this year.
Without a doubt, especially on defense, just because they have 8 returning starters. I think 8 of them are seniors as well. They're very experienced. And with them, they're always fast. They're really fast. Probably one of the fastest defenses we're going to play. They're real physical. They do a lot of good things on defense. I think, in the scouting report, we saw that they've ran at least 52 different defensive fronts this year. They blitz. They just show a lot of different things that we got to be on point with, especially the offensive line and, blitz pickup and whatnot. And on the back end, they're not going to do anything fancy. They're going to play man coverage or they're going to play cover 3. So, that's going to be a challenge for, us as an offense. Kellen getting the ball out of his hands and then us receivers winning our one-on-one battle. So we're excited about it. Like you said, the past 2 years, we haven't put up crazy numbers against them or whatnot, but just because they're a real solid defense. But, we're looking forward to getting the win, whichever way we can. Mm-hmm.
Christian Kirk with us here on Studio 12, the Friday edition. Aggies and Gamecocks tomorrow night at 6:30 at Kyle Field. And it's kind of cliche, but I'm going to ask you anyways, because you are one of these key leaders, the key leader of this group. You've got your core guys of leaders. And you got a lot of young guys. You guys are walking through this season. How proud are you of your team and the way that they didn't, as young as they are, they didn't feel sorry for themselves. They didn't fold. They didn't quit anything. When you get down 21-7, how proud are you of the way that they just kind of stayed the course?
Very proud. Very proud with the, like you said, the way that they stayed the course and just kept fighting. It's definitely, a contributing, factor when you have a bunch of, leaders on the team or a group of core guys that have been there before and, are able to go up and down the sideline and kind of set the tone. I know when we were down 21-7, I was going up and down the sideline, I better not see anybody's heads hanging, because we still have, I think that was the middle of the second quarter, if I'm not mistaken. We still have a lot of football to be played, and we've seen, what's happened when we're on the other side of the ball, when we're up, those are many points. So it was good, and then I think the best part about it was not only having a group of core leaders to be able to, keep the team's aspirations up and the spirit up, was just to have a head coach that does it with you as well. He brings the team up when we're about to go into overtime, and it's all smiles. He's smiling. he's, you know, hey, we've been here before. You guys already know what we're about to do. You know, this is our thing, overtime. And he said, we already know how to finish. And to have him smiling and then, you know, me and Armani and, you know, Cullen jumping up and down smiling, I mean, you can't help but not to feed off of that type of energy and to see the other guys kind of react to that and be like, okay, you know, we're all right. We're going to win this. I think it's a good thing, and I'm really happy, you know, the place we finished in on Saturday.
And then, you know, you as much as you're part of that celebration in the locker room that we've all seen the video, I'm sure a little part of you is enjoying watching Coach Sullivan getting in the middle of that and having a good time too. Huh?
Yeah, without a doubt. You know, definitely with, you know, just the amount of outside noise that, you know, I'm sure he has to deal with, you know, on a daily basis, you know, we deal with it as well. And, you know, it just shows, you know, how much, you know, that locker room means to him and, you know, means to us, and just to be able to have fun and just know how hard we work for it. That's the best part about it, is to be able to spray those water bottles in there.
Yeah. Night before the movie. It was The Kingsman, right?
The Kingsman.
Yeah.
The sequel to the first Kingsman.
Yeah.
I did enjoy the first Kingsman. I'd probably give that one a 2.5.
Okay. Sequels have a hard time matching.
Yeah.
I will say this Kingsman, 1.5.
Wow.
So you're not disappointed that you watched it, but it wouldn't necessarily be a movie that you would go see again?
No.
Okay.
It didn't live up to the first Kingsman, which is hard. Okay. But I just didn't really. I thought it was a little corny here and there, and just the plot and whatnot just wasn't my. And I, like I said, I'm an action movie type of guy, and that's all action movie, you know, kind of, you know, Secret Service-ish. Just didn't like it. Just wasn't very well put together.
So your early leader so far in the season. Well, I guess you saw it on your own, but would it be your favorite one you've seen so far in the fall?
Yes, that one with Wind River, not far behind.
Yeah, because you gave it a 3.
Yes,
Wind River. I think it's like 2.75.
So he was up there.
Yeah, it was a great movie.
It's on my list now.
All right. Yeah, I know. I did. The only movie critic I go off of is Christian Kirk.
And don't forget, my grandma gave Wind River a 5 as well.
That's right. That bumped your rating up a little bit.
The rating up there.
Well. Hey, we appreciate the time as always. Good luck Saturday night, South Carolina here at Kyle Field.
Appreciate it.